tutorial on how to record your slideshow in PowerPoint on a Mac because it looks a little bit different. And you'll also still be able to export as a video file just like you could on a PC. That's actually one of the newer features they've added into PowerPoint on a Mac. So here is the presentation that I have. Right now I have some notes written in. I don't have any on this page, but I have my script written out below my slides here on all those pages. This way it'll make my recording process go much more smoothly. I am going to start at the beginning, and under the slideshow tab at the top, there's a button that says record slideshow. When I push this, it's going to bring me to the presenter view of the screen. It actually starts recording right away once I start moving into here. You can see that this counter is going, so it is setting timings on my slides and it is recording what I'm saying right now if I was going to export this. If I started talking and I messed up on this slide and I needed to start over, I can simply hit this restart button here and then push play. Once I see that timer going, it's going to pick up and it'll rewrite over what I'm doing on that slide. So really, you can just record one slide's worth at a time. It tells you the current time that your recording is on that particular slide as you're going. I'm looking over here, there's a few other options. Your notes that you put in over here will show up over here. I know in the past, I'm not seeing them on this slide, but I have seen, when I have my dual screens going, which I don't right now, I've had some annotation features over here so I could draw while I'm recording. I'm not seeing them right now, but honestly, I never use those. I prefer to have my animations in. If you try to draw while you're recording on PowerPoint, it just winds up looking clunky. Most people can't draw well with their mouse or trackpad anyway. So I would just prefer to use animation features to do any kind of annotation in advance. When I'm ready with this slide and I'm ready to move to the next one, I can either push this arrow button over here with my mouse, or I can also navigate these slides with my keyboard arrow. So I can push the right arrow to go to the next one. And again, as soon as I moved over, it's telling me over here that it is recording still. I usually give it about 1 second just to make sure I don't cut myself off in that transition. If I mess up here, I can again redo it and then push play. And now actually when I'm, if I exported this video recording, I'd be recording over myself at that moment. So it's pretty easy if you mess up. What's nice is I have those notes that I put in over here and I can see them just to read while I am doing this. If they're too tiny like they are right now, I can just hit this font arrow and I can make it nice and large for me to see and read while I'm recording. Again, I usually use my keyboard arrows and I build in all my animation just to make this run smoothly so I'm not re-recording this multiple times. I'll push the arrow over. Now I'm on the next screen. I can just read my script for this one and I can keep going. I'm going to go over here and I'm going to read this script here. This slide has some built-in animations. So what's nice here is this part of my screen is showing me what's currently being recorded. That's what's on the screen. And this is the next animation that's ready. So this is one of those screens where I had some pop-up animations. I have this green box that pops up as I'm talking about it. One tip that I have for you, if you're writing your script, I put an asterisk when I want to hit the forward button, when I want the animation to appear, so that it's just a little visual cue for me. As I'm reading my script, I see an asterisk, I know that's when I should push my over arrow so that I'm able to get the animations at the time that I want to see them. So that's a little tip from me to you. So as I'm pushing over, my arrows aren't working because I was clicking on the text. So I'm going to read those animations and I have a few more that pop up. Okay, I'm going and I'm recording almost at the end. Great. So that's the end of my slideshow. When I'm ready, I just click end show. Now this pop-up will come up and it says the total time is this long. Do you want to save the new timings? I'll say yes. And you can see here now that I'm on my slideshow that there's a certain amount of time on each slide and there's this audio icon, so I know there's a recording on each slide. If you don't want to see this view, I can go back to view and see the normal view like this. That's what we're used to seeing. And I can see here for sure I do have an audio file here. Now, I can share this with someone right now, and what it just does is that when I share this presentation, they can go in PowerPoint and push play, and it will play my narrations on each slide. That is one option for sharing it with your students. However, if you want to post it as a video so that maybe you can keep track of the number of views, or you want to put it into a tool like Edpuzzle, then you can go ahead and export this as an actual video file that can go up on a YouTube channel or an Office 365 channel. To do that, you're going to go to, I have to get to the, Macs are weird and have two sets of toolbars. So not this toolbar, but the top toolbar. And you're going to go to File, Export, and you will export it, change the file format to an MP4. You could also do a .mov. Both of those would upload fine, but an MP4 is a pretty general, universal video file format. So if I do that, I can change the quality of the presentation. I usually just pick internet quality that'll shrink the size down just a little bit, but still make it viewable on a tool like YouTube. Click export, and it'll take a second to render the video and send it wherever you just told it to save, and then you will have a video file of your PowerPoint.